Hey everybody, it is Michelle, Shelly D, here with another Words of Wisdom. So, really quickly, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at Shelly D Cotton. Subscribe to my YouTube channel at Michelle Cotton. We're going to jump right in today, y'all, because we have a great topic. So, I love you. Is it too soon? Too early? That's the topic of today. So today we're talking about those three powerful words, I love you. Men and women alike. I already know, I can already see and feel and envision your faces. And you're going, Michelle, it's just so crucial when you hear that, especially if you think it may be too soon. Is there anything wrong with saying I love you? No. Could it be some negative consequences if you say it too soon? Yeah. Could it be some positive results if you say it too soon? Yeah. So let's jump right in. So three things I got for you today. The first one is how. Well, how what? How do you know? Or how do you think you know that you love me? First of all, the main question or the main response when someone says I love you too early is, how? You don't know me. Especially in this whole world of dating through an app or, you know, you're meeting somebody through online dating. Like, it's really, really crazy. If someone develops those type of feelings in the first month, people just tend to seem very suspicious and be uncomfortable. We'll say it like that. So, you don't know me. Well, let me say this. If the chemistry and the connection is really, really good and you guys have spent a lot of time together in a short period of time, I'm talking about both male and female, whichever person says I love you first, and they may say it early on during the dating process, you do feel like you know someone, or you can know a lot about someone in a short period of time, especially if you have hit it off. Again, the chemistry is great, the connection is there, you spend a lot of time with this person, and those feelings come up naturally, and you're ready to say it. Let me say this, mean it though. Mean it. If you're gonna say I love you, mean that junk, man. It's not junk, I'm sorry. Mean that word, mean that phrase, because it should not be taken lightly. So that's the first thing. You don't know me. I love you. You don't know me well enough to love me. Well, if we've been dating for a month, or let's even say 2 months, and every day we're spending time with each other, like you're over here or you're over there or whatever, you know, whatever. I think someone can definitely fall quickly, and those feelings are true that you can love the other person very soon, early on during the process. The other one is, oh, it's just infatuation. You guys, that infatuation word just gets me, because there are some people who are just not infatuated with other people. There are some people who you don't have no infatuation with. They could be very attractive, have be a good, compassionate, considerate, caring person, and you fall for them, but it's not infatuation. Again, you really love that person. You really are into that person. You have fallen in love with that person, and it's not a weird thing. But again, respect the fact that too soon, too early can make someone else feel uncomfortable. The other thing is, which I've heard, you guys, you know that I tell you things that I experience. I'm very transparent. I have been one to say I love you very early on during the dating process. I'm not gonna justify by saying, oh, it's a nice loving person or whatever, but in all honesty and sincerity, you can, because I've experienced it, to really love someone. And it'd be more than just platonic. Like, you really can see yourself with this person. And those feelings can come early on. So don't beat yourself up every day about it if you're that person who... Y'all hear Barack? He's really tripping today. That's how y'all know I'll be doing this live in action. But anyway, don't beat yourself up if you're that person who gets those feelings. And again, mean it. They are genuine. They are authentic. And you do love the person. Just be aware and be cautious of what can happen when you say it, good or bad, right? The other thing is liar. Now, I will say this. I hear this from most men, which is so crazy, more than women in my experience. Men, not all, a lot of men have shared with me that when the woman or the, you know, the female says, I love you, in a relationship, and they say it too soon. Oh my goodness, Barack. I love you, Barack. I do. I love my dog. He's my pit bull. He's doing a lot today. But when people say, or when the guy tells me that she said she loves him and it was too soon, too early, they think that the girl is lying. This is what I heard. True story. This is what I hear a lot. That, oh my goodness, Michelle, they are telling me a lie. They said it to every guy. And I'm just going, no judgment. No judgment zone when I'm coaching. But I do look. I just look. Because the question that's rolled through my mind, and I'm probably going to just give myself away now to my clients or some other people who may potentially want to come and receive coaching from me, I'm always going, well, why do you think that she's lying? And I have asked that question sometime when we're at that level in the coaching process. I have asked, well, why do you think she's lying? Because she said, I love you early. And some of the feedback that I do get, the comments that I get is, well, how, Michelle, can she love me this soon? She don't know me. Or she tells that to every guy that she's been with, and it's just a hoax, and it's just a lie, it's just some game, it's just, you know, a manipulation. You know how y'all do. You know, I get that too. Men are very bold, even in coaching, they're very outspoken. And you know, again, no judgment, and I can get it to a certain degree, but here again, it may not be a lie. Trust people until they give you a reason not to. So those are three for how. Oh, you don't know me. It's infatuation. And most women, again, because I hear it from men more so than women. I haven't heard a woman come to me and say, when a guy tells her that he loves her, that she thinks it's a lie. And now women, we are nurturers. We are more emotional. And we really believe it. And the funny thing about it, men could be lying. No judgment. Not saying that all men lie when they say I love you, because it takes a lot for a man to say that I love you. I do know that I have brothers and I have a daddy. So yeah, it's not like something they're throwing out there so lightly. But I have experienced a guy who told me very early on, and I must say I was like, oh, I was uncomfortable. And I wasn't ready, but I was in a season of my life where I was just coming out of something. Not a relationship, I was coming out from of a self-identity process. And when I got hit with that, it kind of took me back. It kind of threw me a little bit. But I didn't call the guy a liar, and I didn't act all crazy. I didn't run off. I just was like, you love me. It's been 3 weeks. But I get it. Moving on. Fear. Fear, people. Fear is a big one. When you say I love you too early or too soon, it brings fear. When I tell you, it's gripping to a lot of people, especially to men. Again, not just trying to single men out, but when a woman says they love them to men too soon, they are, pew, most of them are out the door. They will run off. Those words will run them off. Why? Because they can't handle it. No mistake. I'm not saying that men are weak or anything like that, but it's a lot. Because like I always tell you guys, We look at men as if they don't get hurt in relationships. We look at them like they are the tough ones, the strong ones, the abusive ones all the time, the ones who mistreat the woman. That's not true, you guys. Women can be very brutal. Women can be very brutal in relationships. I'm a woman. I ain't gonna sit here and lie to y'all and say that I have not had some old ways where I mistreated some men. Lord, I've asked for forgiveness and I've repented for my sins and I have put it all out there and reconciled with some past relationships that I knew I was just being a royal jerk, pain in the butt, very cold. So we gotta realize that men, they do get hurt in relationship as well. So if they hear that too soon, it can run them off, it can scare them, it can definitely raise concerns for them. They can't handle it because they wonder why. And if you're in something, and let's just hypothetically say the treatment from him hasn't been the greatest, how, why does she love me? You know, why do you love me? I haven't even given you good reasons to love me. I hope that's not the case, but you know, man, woman, you know. Also, it's a big trust issue in the fear. Again, people, and I say people, men and women, have been so damaged from relationships, from the wrong choices in relationship, from decision making that was poor, mistreatment, manipulation. So trust is a big issue for people to believe that someone can love them so soon in the dating process or in the relationship. It's a real thing. The other thing is rejection. Again, we don't know background, and I'm touching this just really briefly because we don't know all the past history. We don't know his or her prior relationships before you. And we have to really accept the fact that that rejection, that mistreatment, if they have experienced that, and then you come along, and you could be very genuine and sincere when you say that you love them and mean it. You could mean it. And it's just not received because of prior damage. You know, mistrust in other relationships. And I'm not even talking about boyfriend-girlfriend relationships. It could be mother-son, mother-daughter, daddy-son, daddy-daughter, that can bring up that rejection and that mistrust, and those fears can rise, and you mean it. You're sincere that you love them because you do, but they can't receive that from you. They can't handle that. That's what I mean by they can't handle it. They're not in a place to receive that from you, and there's absolutely nothing you can do about it. Now, you can choose to continue to love them, and prayerfully, if it's in the will of God, that he, she will understand it and begin to have the same mutual feelings, but I mean, that's out of your control, right? It's out of your control. Because we just can never know what they dealt with prior to your relationship with them. Okay, the next thing is mental and emotional. So this is kind of a big one, but I'm not gonna really go into it. I may do a part two of this next week. I'm not really sure, but I may. Mental and emotional. First of all, mentally, I love you affects people. It's an impactful word. Love is action. Love is an action word. It is operative. So when you say I love you to someone, you want them to understand it. You want to have demonstrated that. You know, don't, and this is just my advice to anybody who's listening, don't say I love you and you have not demonstrated that love. You have not shown that love. And I'm talking about in different aspects, mentally, emotionally, physically, you know, supportive. If you have not been that person to demonstrate love, it's going to be very hard and misunderstanding and confusing for someone to receive that from you. And I'm just going to be honest, if you can't be telling me, oh, I love you, and everything that you're doing shows me you don't love me. And I'm not talking about love languages here. Your love language is not being a jerk to me. Your love language is not, whoa, do y'all hear me wrong? I got to take a pause for the cause. He's doing me today. Did anybody want to come get Barack today? I know y'all don't because everybody's scared of him. He ain't but a big baby though. But y'all hear him? He trying my patience. But I love him though. He's my emotional support doggy. He's my companion. Okay. So, don't just throw that out there without it being. I swear every time I start talking, he starts getting crazy. But anyway, don't just throw it out there. Like, 100%. Y'all come get him. Come get him. He trying me. I will bring him on this camera because I want him to really, I want y'all to see him right now. Okay, so what you do want to hope is that the feeling is mutual. You want to hope that if you do say that, which is not going to be the case, most times it's not going to be the case. If you say I love you too soon, the other person, 9 times out of 10, they don't love you yet. They may never love you, okay? So be prepared, again, if you say that, how it will be received.